where you guys were at halftime and the way things went, especially in that second half, just what stood out to you and kind of what was your biggest concern?
My biggest concern is our offense in the second half. Obviously, you got to give them credit with their physicality, but I think they did it in the first half too. We just end up shooting 20 mid-range shots and 11 points of turnovers in the second half, and that just kills you. And that's the result. Like, they call a timeout when we're up 9 in the third, and then from there everything goes downhill, and it's back-to-back turnovers, and it's all of us should have helped them better with play calling and what to do and whatnot. But obviously this is just a game that we all have to look at ourselves in the mirror and be better tomorrow, watch film. Going to help them with don't do this again. 31 threes to 20 mid-range shots is pretty awful, so we just don't want to do that.
Defensively, you talked about the physicality that Detroit brought there in the second half. Was there anything different that kind of slowed down that offense that you saw specifically?
From them to us? Yeah, their ball pressure, I think they did a great job. And then they put us in the line and we didn't make free throws. So, you know, it is what it is. Free throws is something that you got to make them, but, you know, you got to move on to the next day. And then when you shoot them, just shoot them. We know all our guys are more than capable to make free throws. And right there, we also lost that battle on the makes, not on the attempts. But, you know, it's part of the game. We just got to be better tomorrow. That's a good thing about the NBA. It's just going to take me tonight to watch film and come back excited tomorrow.
Jordy, in the paint, I think the Pistons scored their first 5 points in the paint. I guess it was almost like an ominous sign because they kept attacking the paint, whether it was scoring inside or rebounding you guys. What do you attribute to that? Was it just them being aggressive, or was it just something going on with either with paint defense or protecting the rim?
They scored 44 points in the paint. It's an okay number, but they play slower pace, so I don't know the overall numbers. You know, probably the percentage is not what I want. But, yeah, we should have been better. A lot of times we pressure, we get blown by, and the low man is not there. We just got to be more disciplined with being there and doing it without fouling. It happened early into the game, but then we found a few good stops pressuring the ball and getting stops. That's why we won that second quarter, 23-32. I think that was our best quarter by far. And then we just, you know, like, couldn't sustain it in the second half. So, once again, the rim and the paint can be an issue, but we know we're a ball pressure team and we cannot get bored with it. And today it felt like we just couldn't keep our mind focused for four quarters.
Did that also attribute to the rebounding, you think, too?
Yeah, the rebounding numbers, we lost right there. It was 7-7 and second chance points in the first half, 14-10 for the game. So they had another 7, we had 3. So it's not like crazy number. Obviously, everything adds up. But again, I think that, you know, if we protect the rim better, we foul a little less defensively. The way I feel right now, I have to watch it. Maybe tomorrow I'll tell you different, but I feel like we should be fine. Offensively is the worst I've seen us play, so.
Cam Thomas has, I think he's yet to get over 4 assists in a game this season. Obviously, that doesn't tell the whole story. You've alluded to a potential assist. Today is only 2. Just what did you see today, and just what have you seen from him on film in terms of the playmaking department and any areas that you'd potentially like to see him grow there?
Yeah, I see frustration, and that's what we need to move on from. Like, I know that, I mean, if you're guarded by their best defender and they're very physical, that tells you that you're a good player. So you just got to move on. And that's what I want him to do, is give us that energy. Obviously, you're not going to be able to score every time. You can find a way to help your team score. And today, CT wasn't efficient. Like sometimes when that happens is you give yourself up with cuts or you find your teammates. And that's what I want to see is your scorer. But if they do certain things to you, then maybe it's a day that you score less, but you assist more. And that's part of the growth. That's part of the growth that we all want to see. So far, he's done an amazing job today, not just CT, but everybody else. It's not where we want to be, definitely.
Jordy, I understand Ben's game is about passing, getting everybody involved, but do you need him to be more aggressive than four shots in 25 minutes?
Yeah, I want him to shoot more than that. My goal for him is at 10, so he's got to find a way to get there. He hasn't gotten there yet, but I know he can. I mean, he is physically getting where he's supposed to be, and then those attempts need to go up because then we all going to benefit from it. I don't care about makes, misses. I just want to see that shots going up, and he's more than capable to do it, so he'll get there for sure.
Is there any concern with Noah Clowney? We saw him get hurt, he stayed in, but do you have any concern with him, especially when it comes to how he's feeling physically and availability for tomorrow?
Not that I know of. I know right now, usually after games, we assess every single player, so I'll get the report. Right now, I haven't been told anything, so we'll see what the medical and performance tell me.
And with third quarters, when you look at just like the numbers overall, is there what have you seen from the third quarter from your team, and what do you want to kind of see them change, especially coming out the half?
It's a good question. I think we started the quarter well, where we took a 9-point lead and they called timeout. So I don't think the start of that quarter. A lot of times is the last two games, we were playing with a lead. And we haven't had that before, a bigger lead. And learning that is a process too, especially with a younger team. Right now we had the lead the last game against Chicago. We lost it. We pushed back. We won the game. Today we had a lead to start the half. We built it to 9, and then it went downhill. So you have to understand that in the game, in the NBA, it's not like – you win the whole game and you win. Like, that's very uncommon. Like, it's a game of runs and very good players. So that focus and consistency has to be there. It's got to be on both ends. So I'm going to demand that from our guys. I think they're playing hard, physicality, all that right now is just keep doing what the team needs you to do offensively. Give yourself up with cuts, touch the paint, find your teammates, you open, shoot it, you know, all that, all those great things that they've been so far doing well. We just struggle in that second half.